Ina Astroskaya and Yuri Kavashnin of the Soviet Union finished third in the Soviet Nationals, fifth in the European Championships recently held in Hungary.
Overhead. Now, it wasn't very good stretch on the top of that. These are the side-by-side double loops. Actually, the movements here are not particularly difficult. But woe be to the skater that doesn't do them spectacularly. Side-by-side sit spins.
Soviet pair won the Junior World Championships last year, and here they are in the Olympics.
Death spiral. Her legs not stretched quite as much as they could be. Their serpentine step movements. Nice knee switching at the end. Their final move, the pair combination spin. Remember, they must first skate as a pair and then change the positioning within it. Very nice, very nice.
17-year-old Marina Astroskaya and 19-year-old Yuri Kavashnin, one of three Soviet pairs competing here in the short program, again worth 29% of the overall score.
You know, they were very good. They just weren't brilliantly outstanding in any one particular form. Here we see them into the death spot. You can see her left leg is bent. It would be far better if that were stretched out. And of course, that is what makes that an extremely difficult move. And in their last combination pair spin, you see them going from the camel position down into a sit spin position. Nice stretch on her leg at this point. But the overall aspect of the combination spin was nice, but not great.
They're very young. Again, they won the World Junior Championships last year.
And there she is with Stanislas Zhuk. Now, he is a character of all time. He's been teaching everybody in Russian pair skating for years and years and years. He had a little drinking problem at one time, but they kind of said, look, you're going to straighten up or you're not going to teach pair skating anymore. So he straightened up, and he's one of the nicest, most funny and humorous guys in the business. He's just a terrific teacher.
It's a wonderful name for a character. As you look at their marks for technical merit, ranging from 5.2 all the way up to 5.5.
And those marks seem pretty relatively high.
I'd say so, comparatively speaking, in comparison to what we've seen thus far tonight. Now, artistic impression for the Soviet pair, ranging from 5.2 up to 5.4, so quite consistent there. The pair of Luan Bo and Yao Bin. She is 26 years old, he is just 18.
They've been very serious during the practice here, working very hard, keeping very much to themselves, very respectful of the entire order of championship. Here's their first move in overhead. Double loops.
They are the only pair from China. They are the Chinese national champions.
Here's their side-by-side sit spins. the way, these spins require turns on each foot. Full number of turns on each foot.
They finished 13th in the World Championships in 1982, the ones held in Copenhagen.
Here's the split twist. Very old sport in China. It goes back several hundred years. The prints and the lithographs of the periods show it. But as a competitive sport, it's very new. It's only been in the last few years that a program has been developed, a serious program has been developed, and these are the first few skaters that we have seen out in between 1980 and 1984. And as of course, it takes a great deal of time to develop a background and a tradition in the sport of figure skating.
Yes, they are still very much in the developmental stage.
This young pair, very, very nice the way that movement was intended to be. They didn't quite, of course, carry it out. But the thought behind it was very interesting.
Yao Bin and Luan Bo representing China. Got a nice warm response from the crowd at the Zetra Arena.
Now, this kind of mistake in a death spiral shows how tricky it can be. You can see her back there. He must continue that extension, that arm out, and he must keep her out in a wide swing. If not, he's going to lose control. And of course, there you can see he did keep her out, and he went back, and of course, that left her without any support.
And the scores are very, very low as they appear here now in the threes, and the judge from the Soviet Union did give them a 4. That's the highest mark. Better marks here for artistic impression. As you can see, the Soviet judge again gave them the highest mark, 4.7, all the way down to 4.0.